I think we even if we lost the first game, I think we started the tournament well, I would say, just because of the way we approached the game and the training that we have done. So pretty confident before the game tomorrow and this training session as well. Yeah, we are looking forward to it and get ready for the game.
Wicket, there was a collapse like 7 wickets at a time. So was it a worrying factor for team management?
Yeah, I think the collapses shouldn't really happen, and we sure would look forward not to replicate that and to learn from our mistakes. And as I said, it was our first game of the season, so there can be a bit of hiccups, but if we don't repeat it in the tournament, we'll be really happy. And yeah, as I said, it was just one game, and it's good that we just went through that game.
When Rahul Tripathi was batting at the top of the order, he was quite successful. Do you believe he should be, you know, brought back to his original position to be more successful?
See, if you look at our batting lineup at the moment, there are quite a few batsmen who are doing well at the in the top order. So, well, it depends on what kind of role the captain and the management wants to give up to a particular player. And I feel they see Rahul, who can actually be batting at any position in the order and still playing that role well, other than other players. I mean, better than other players. So, yeah, there are quite a few players who play the top order, but then you have to play someone down the order as well. So maybe they find Rahul is the guy who can fit in that into that role. But having said that, it's pretty flexible, and you can see him batting up or someone batting down in the tournament, in the going further in the tournament as well.
Now, what sort of an impact did action has on the team?
Sorry, I didn't get it. To be honest, we didn't even mention it once after that day. We have all moved on from that incident, and it's time that we focus on the game coming up. It's a big game, and every game is going to be crucial, as we all know, in a tournament like this. So doesn't really make any kind of impact on us, and we're looking forward just for what we can do to win the game tomorrow, and the processes that we can do for that doesn't really make any impact of that sort. Not really. I just came in straight after the from the bus, so haven't looked at the pitch yet.
Josh Butler was in tremendous form towards the end, later part of the last IPL, and he started off in the same fashion this season. How much of pressure does that put on the other batsmen?
Well, it actually adds to the confidence for the other batsmen as well, because if someone starts the inning like that, I think the batting lineup actually gets a lot of confidence out of it, and people can always learn from the way he's been playing, or he has been approaching the game, and it's been good for us. It's been tremendous for us in throughout the last season, not just the 5-6 games, but even if he was batting down the order, I think he suited that role as well. And now that he is in prime form, I think it's about just building those partnerships with him, the other batsmen, if they can contribute with him. I think it can't be just Butler winning us games. It has to be individuals who have to step forward to win us a more number of games going further in the tournament. So him being in prime form is a great advantage for us, but as I said, it's going to be about everyone contributing at different times in the tournament going forward.
How much of an, now you've spent a lot of time with Stephen Jones right now, what improvements have you had during this course with him? And secondly, the bowling unit of Rajasthan Royals is largely of players with limited international experience. It's a very raw, young bowling attack. So, who's the one who helps you all step up against international quality batsmen? That
to step up the game, I think everyone does it individually. Obviously, the captain is there, the coaches are there to boost you and to boost the confidence and to help you out in the training sessions. But I feel if you're playing at a level as such, you have to have it inside you, and you have to push yourself rather than others pushing you. So I think it's even if we don't have as much experience as other sides have regarding the bowling unit, I still feel we have the talent to go forward. And Stefan being here is obviously a lot of help to all of us. He has his own ideas and thoughts about going about fast bowling. You know, his trainings is the way he trains us, or the way he asks us to train, is very specific to fast bowling, and he has had a lot of experience doing that back in UK. So I was excited to meet him, and now that I have got to know him a bit as well, I think it's helping all of us who are actually working with him. And as a collective unit as well, I think if I look at the kind of individuals that we have in our unit, I think we have the firepower to go further in the tournament.
Team India is still looking for the left-arm pacer for the upcoming World Cup. So you think you are still in the competition and can fill that place?
Well, at the moment, my focus is to win games for Rajasthan. And doesn't really matter if I have that in my mind or no. I think it's high time in my career where I look at just enjoying every single game that I play. That's what I've been saying throughout this domestic season when I was asked this question as well. That it's that time of my career where I want to really focus on enjoying as a player, contributing to the team now that I'm at the peak of my career. And these 5 years are going to be the time where I will be at my peak as a fast. I think we, even if we lost the first game, I think we started the tournament well, I would say. Just because of the way we approached the game and the training that we have done. So pretty confident before the game tomorrow. And this training session as well, yeah, we are looking forward to it and get ready for the game.
Wicket, there was a collapse like 7 wickets at a time. So was it a worrying factor for team management?
Yeah, I think the collapses shouldn't really happen, and we sure would look forward not to replicate that and to learn from our mistakes. And as I said, it was our first game of the season, so there can be a bit of hiccups, but if we don't repeat it in the tournament, we'll be really happy. And yeah, as I said, it was just one game, and it's good that we just went through that game.
When Rahul Tripathi was batting at the top of the order, he was quite successful. Do you believe he should be, you know, brought back to his original position to be more successful in?
See, if you look at our batting lineup at the moment, there are quite a few batsmen who are doing well at the in the top order. So, well, it depends on what kind of role the captain and the management wants to give up to a particular player, and I feel they see Rahul, who can actually be batting at any position in the order and still playing that role well, other than other players. I mean, better than other players. So, yeah, there are quite a few players who play the top order, but then you have to play someone down the order as well. So maybe they find Rahul is the guy who can fit in that into that role. But having said that, it's pretty flexible, and you can see him batting up or someone batting down in the tournament, in the going further in the tournament as well.
Now, what sort of an impact did Akshin's action has on the team?
Sorry, I didn't hear. To be honest, we didn't even mention it once after that day. We have all moved on from that incident, and it's time that we focus on the game coming up. It's a big game, and every game is going to be crucial, as we all know, in a tournament like this. So doesn't really make any kind of impact on us, and we're looking forward just for what we can do to win the game tomorrow, and the processes that we can do for that doesn't really make any impact of that sort.